It started out being purely functional. That thing became a style leader. I guess it's very American. We are the people who always head west and make something out of nothing. This one item of clothing has transitioned through all those times and found its place.
I feasted on cowboy films, images of cowboy stars wearing jeans. I mean, it just one went with the other.
I did grow up in Texas. And cowboys, you don't want to take them home to mom and dad, but like you certainly want to be on the dance floor with them.
My fantasy was to be a cowboy. Levi's were a part of having a cowboy outfit in the movies. They all wore jeans, man.
And can you imagine John Wayne in baggy jeans? I mean, wouldn't work. I don't know how they got stylish in the general public, but somehow they did.
The Western films of the 30s meant the whole country wanted a piece of the cowboy lifestyle. For the first time, folks were wearing 501s for its look. Nonetheless, function always informed its evolving design.
They're a representation of every period in the same way as a good piece of design is. If you see an Ames chair in the middle of a bunch of garbage, you go directly towards it. And Levi's are that way too. It's perfect design.
All of these evolutions and changes were because there was a specific need or because it functioned better.
Form fits function. So if you build it to last, the fashion comes second.
All classics were born out of utility.
It comes from people who needed to work in them. And I think that story, it makes me feel like I'm not buying into something that is a statement. It works. It's not trying to communicate really anything.
It is made of four pieces of fabric, essentially, because if there was more, there would be more seams and it would be able to rip in more places.
I don't want anything around me, even a pencil or anything that's not well designed. A 501 jean is as plain as a glass of water.
In 1934, the first women's jeans appear. Lady Levi's are in Vogue magazine a year later. They'd come a long way from the mine. By the 50s, Hollywood stars had elevated this humble utilitarian garment to a newfound glamorous status. The 501 became a fashion icon.
Maybe the sexiness of a woman wearing jeans is the idea of playing with masculinity and femininity.
If you put an incredible beauty like Marilyn Monroe in like Levi's and some rugged look just shows how beautiful and feminine and sexy they are.
You have James Dean and you have everybody in the 50s is like, man, wearing jeans means you're cool and you're a rebel.
You know, it's like, it's sort of against the law to just be the chick that's just like happy with wearing jeans and a t-shirt.
That's what society was telling women that they wanted us to look like. And women kind of said, wait a minute, no, my butt looks amazing in these, so I'm gonna do this instead.
These are 501s, and they're a good place to keep my hands.
I am wearing a short man's jeans. I like to see my boots.
These are the 1955. They're just rock and roll.
I did street racing with my Camaro. A good set of cowboy boots, Levi's 501s, white shirt, or like today, the whole red shirt.
As I've gotten older, I like them a little bit higher.
How it's tapered, if it's cropped, if they cut it, if it's with a wingtip, if it's with a perfect cuff.
It was a whole math part of buying the jeans. Your inseam should be 2 inches and your waist should be 3 inches, and then they're gonna shrink and then they become perfect.
When I saw this, I was just really, really happy.
Perfect air condition. Good for riding a bike, the wind blows right up.
The cool thing with Levi's, they're easy to manipulate, tweak, reconstruct, rework, reinterpret.
I rolled them in the dark. It's a bit indecent, it's a little.
I'm a 501 guy for 20 plus years.
You either had to wear women's jeans or I would get 501s and then sew them up.
I would taper the ankles and just be like moshing with 50 sweaty boys plus me.
If your grandmother sews you ripped crotch or ripped knee with a little strawberry patch, that's yours. I mean, I never had that done.
Some girls will like wear out like two little holes on the little butt cheek.
What a lot of people want to say when they're wearing 501s is that, you know, I'm almost above trend.
Yeah, kind of a few holes, you know. I had these for like 100 years.
501s, penny loafers, and a white beefy tee t-shirt. It attracted the girls. Let's be honest.
My mom was always like, you gotta wash it, that's dirty. But I was like, no, I like the jeans crispy. I like money crispy, and I like my jeans crispy.
And I saw this Levi's ad on the big screen. It's in my mind and in my soul. It's in my generation. You gotta live it alive and walk it alive and live it in jubilation. I said, Levi's, Levi's. You gotta walk in the Levi's.